Yeah, man, I read that call up on the machine, man. And I have to say this again, one more time. You can't understand. Our teacher or a principal who should have been the role model of the country, or the role model of Jamaica, or role model of every country around the world. Or they come to that conclusion to put an 8-year-old kid out of school because she, her ears pierced, or she had an earring, she wear an earring come to school. You better than take the earring and call the parents and tell them that she can't wear it. But you can't put an 8-year-old kid out of school. When you do that to an 8-year-old kid, you're blighting the kid's future. And you as a principal, or you as a teacher, should have been the role model. We the people have to play our part in our crime and violence in the country, in the island of Jamaica. And if we can't be able to educate our kids, we can stop crime and violence. So when you put a kid out of school, any teacher at all or any principal agree, or the Ministry of Education agree to make a teacher or a principal put a kid out of school. Simply telling the world that we don't care about crime, so we're not going to fight crime. We're just going to allow crime to grow to the dimension we want to grow to. Because if you're going to look for an 8-year-old kid, we have to start nurturing him from this. We have to start teaching the rights and show him what is right and wrong. Show him the way of the world and make him understand the levels of good and bad. And you put him out of school, 8-year-old girl child like that. It tells me what Jamaica is coming to. Yeah, it tells me what Jamaica is coming to. And it not tells me alone. It tells the whole world what Jamaica is coming to. New Hope Primary School in a White House. They put out a little 8-year-old child out of school the other day. VW granddaughter. And that was nice. I don't know. I don't feel comfortable about it since it come to my attention. So I have to make two talk on Facebook and put it on Facebook for you people to see it. And if the principal watch it, may I beg you to ask, you know, see if you can call the parents of the kids and whatsoever and take back the kids in school. I take the kid back in school. Like that child, specific that child, call it, see if you can call the parents of them and take the kid back in school. And if the parents watching, go down to the school with the child and talk to the principal and get this kid back in school. Because we don't like when kids out of school, that's that. And when a child out of school, is another criminal that you're making. Or another whore or another go-go you're making. We don't need that. That's that. We don't need that. You understand what I'm saying? I don't want to put a brand on anybody, but I'm just saying you gotta make sure we don't make criminals, we don't make go-go, we don't make whores, we don't make killers. And girl child like that, you gotta be careful. In America, there's so many sex crimes there around the world where the people be taking a little girl child and sometimes rip them and kill them and all that. You can't do that. I'll do that now at my Jamaica. Yet. You can't. Putting out an 8-year-old child out of school. So asking the principal and the teacher of New Hope Primary School, or New Hope All Age and Primary School, please to reinstate that kid, and let she go to school. I don't know if the teacher he or she, but this is red hot color for New York. And I used to go to New Hope All Age School when New Hope Primary School. Sorry if I say All Age, New Hope Primary School, when Mr. Reed and Mr. Buckle and Mr. Mack and Miss German and them type of people, Miss Palmer and them type of people, there was a teacher. And those people were some great people. Those people nurtured me. I was a little badass kid, and those people nurtured me. I make me be the man which me be today. You understand? And I never met jail yet, and I don't have to make no jail. You understand? And I don't have to kill nobody, and I don't have to kill nobody. And those teachers was some real good role models. You understand? So you teachers of today, at that school, need to be role models too, as another kid can come talk about you, like how I talk about Mr. Macan, Miss Drummond, Mr. Buckle, and Miss Palmer, Miss Spence, and Miss Heath. Just like how I can talk about those teachers, make some kid can talk about you too. Those teachers never put me out of school when me did bad. Me used to bad, me used to fight, me used to do a lot of things, and they never put me out. No, you understand? So please, see if you can do something to reinstate that kid. Feed a granddaughter and Devon Blair granddaughter. Then just live across from the school over there, in that street right there, right behind Tony Sheep House. Yeah, then just live right there, so across from the school, right behind Tony Sheep House and right behind Otis House. Exactly. So please, see if you can get those kids back into the school. Miss, I don't know who's the principal of New Hope School and the principal of New Hope Primary. I don't know he or she right now. But the teacher who, for the 8-year-old kid, should have really shamed herself. Yeah. And this is Red Hot Color saying that from New York. Yeah. And that's how that goes. We really have to do that and put call some people attention to that. And that's how so it goes. The Ministry of Education has to start to do something about it too. And you teachers, you should have been, I want to be the role model for the youth of tomorrow and today. And if you can't do that, if you put in out a 8-year-old kid out of school, that simply means that you can't be the role model for the youth of today and tomorrow. And Jamaica need that. It's really need that. Thank you. I don't know who it is, but thank you. This is Red Hot Color. In and out, Panawana. Yeah.